that's where I do everything. You heard here, my music is where I record it, in my bedroom. Mm-hmm. All my music has never been in like a big studio or anything. It's just bedroom music.
Hell yeah. When I'm on the mic, I like
Madlib startet som rapper og produsent for undergrunnsheltene Lootback, men har blitt en stadig dårligere skjult hemmelighet. De siste årene har nemlig produksjonene veltet ut fra hjemmestudioet hans i Los Angeles, fra skamroste hiphopplater til jazz- og reggae-prosjekter. Han har mye av æren for at plateselskapet Stone's Throw har fått en høy status blant musikkelskere, og han har ingen planer om å bremse jobbingen med det første.
Working on New Mad Villain 2, New J-Lib 2, YNQ, I mean I have like gang of YNQ albums coming out like 8 and 9. Got an album with my man M.E.D. on Stone's Throw. Working on stuff with Common, Busta Rhymes, De La Soul. Working on some things with Prince Poe, The Last Poets. Possibly an album with Roy Ayers. The new Quasimodo's done. Another Blue Note. I got an old school reggae album coming out where I'm gonna do some like some old crazy stuff, whatever. A lot of other stuff. New Dudley Perkins album. Solo Madlib. Whatever.
Tidligere hadde Madlib studio i kjelleren i huset til den rabiate platesamleren Peanut Butter Wolf. Han grunnleggeren og sjefen i selskapet Stone's Throw Records, som gir ut Madlib og en rekke andre artister fra California.
So this is literally a bomb shelter that was made in the 50s, I guess, when the US and USSR were in this cold war. We called the studio the bomb shelter, you know, because of that. But this is where Madlib did like all of his older releases. There's like records kind of in every room. I've been buying records since I was a young kid, and you know, I've kind of in those years is when I really wanted to start a record label. You know, you're in high school and people ask you what you want to do when you grow up. You know, I wrote a report on it, like how I'm gonna start this record label. Green light, tic tac, so yo, here we go. Red means stop, and green light means go.
Common sense drop, cause I truly love the hip hop. Like da Peanut Butter Wolf og rapperen Charisma hadde vært på et stort selskap i 3 år uten å få gitt ut plate, bestemte Wolf seg for å starte sitt eget selskap. Stone's Throw Records ble startet i 1996 og feiret nylig sin 100. utgivelse. De har fått stadig større oppmerksomhet, mye på grunn av den kreative kraften til Madlib.
You have to like kind of know him to believe what he can do. Madlib, he just has so many ideas in his head. Even when he came to me asking me about doing a jazz album, I didn't understand what he meant because he didn't know how to play instruments. So rather than giving him an artist advance, which most labels do, we went to a keyboard store and just bought everything they had, you know, and he learned them all.
Madlib dannet like godt en jazzkvintett helt på egen hånd. Gruppa Yesterday's New Quintet framstår som en fullverdig gruppe hvor alle medlemmene til og med gir ut soloplater, men egentlig alle en og samme mann.
I have about 10 groups now, 10 instrumental groups. Trios, quartets, whatever you want. I get bored real easy, so, and my vibes switch. Sometimes I'll be making a beat and I'll get bored, so I'll just run to the play drums and end up playing drums for 6 hours, you know, or whatever.
Plata som fikk mange til å sperre øynene opp for Stone's Throw og Madlib, var den jassa psykedeliske kultklassikeren Quasimodo, The Unseen. Men den skulle egentlig aldri ha blitt gitt ut.
Before I got signed to Stone's Throw, you know, I had like 2 albums worth of Quasimodo. You know, I just did that for myself. You know, I used to wear Walkmans, hate my voice, you know, I don't like my voice when I rap, you know, so I tried to do something different, and I had a bag of shrooms.
Good morning, sunshine.
Good morning, sunshine. I ain't the cat you saw yesterday. At least I mean by tomorrow I won't be anyway. Whole new ball game, whole new day.
So I just recorded that album and everybody seemed to like it, so I recorded another one and showed Wolf and put it out. But it was just for myself, you know, I didn't want that stuff to get out.
He was a little surprised, but you know, I know he really liked it, but he didn't think I was gonna like it, I guess.
But that's one of my best selling albums. You know, I didn't expect it to be like that.
What goes around comes around. Always look out. Get to fucking like a hell.
En time nord for Los Angeles ligger Oxnard, hjembyen til Madlib. Her bor mange av de andre Stones Throw-artistene, som Madlibs lillebror, Oh No, og de gamle kollegene i Lootback.
You get more opportunities than a lot of other labels, that, you know what I'm saying? You get more opportunities, you know what I'm saying? So it's a good thing.
You get to keep your own sound instead of, mm-hmm. like, because we were sort of messing with, like, majors. We messed with majors for a while, and they just tried to change the sound, like they were trying to add some more bump or add another snare to Madlib's beat, and we were not, like, nah, we don't want that. So basically, they let us do our own thing, you know. If it was dirty or ghetto sounding, Wolf didn't care.
Stones Throw tilbyr kreativ frihet, men ikke noe særlig penger. For eksempel er DJ Rome sitt studio et rom i huset til mora.
Anthony, do the ears for the camera. Do your ear trick.
Hello.
Yeah. I work at a sports store. Selling like sports hats and products. Look at our rides, look at the studio, man, but we're doing it regardless, you know, regardless if we have money or not, we're gonna be doing it, and that's how we take it.
Madlib har derimot begynt å leve av musikken sin, og har solgt beats til store artister som De La Soul, Common og Busta Rhymes.
Are you hoping for kind of a break into the mainstream?
No, I take a little money, some mainstream money, but I don't need any more. I'm good. I just want the money. I'm a background type of dude, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not trying to be Jay-Z and nothing like that, you know what I'm saying? I've seen how that lifestyle is. I don't want that.